Welcome back. It's time for 11 Fitness, and Candace Grasso is joining us to answer your questions. Good morning. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. Did you stay up?
I did not stay up, no.
I didn't either. I tried to. I fell asleep.
Yeah, I know. You can't on this shift anyway.
No.
But, you know, New Year's Day is really a time where everyone makes their New Year's resolution, and working out and eating right is definitely on the, you know, top two on the list.
It is. And, you know, most years I'll go through a list of resolutions and what the best things are to do. And I actually saw that you all hit that this morning. I saw your segment.
So do you agree with that? Keep small goals?
Absolutely. It has to be small, has to be bite-sized, has to be realistic. And really, if you've done these same resolutions every year, my best advice is, if you haven't been able to make them happen, you know, that insanity thing, doing the same thing over and over again, expecting to get a different result, you got to do some new plan. Try something different to make them happen this year. Well, hire somebody. Do something different.
That really goes in line with a lot of the good questions we have this morning, because it sounds like folks really are trying pretty hard out there. And this first one, it's, I've tried everything, every ab exercise, every video, and still my abs hang over my jeans. Forget a six-pack. I just don't want to have to tuck them into my pants. Help!
Well, you know, these were the top three most frequently asked questions of 2010. I pulled them up. And so I thought, going into the new year, let's just give the scoop on it.
Okay.
It is going to have a lot to do with your diet. Because the issue is, most folks will get, you know, reasonable CDs. They'll get ab machines that work. Please don't get the belt that makes your abs jump. But, you know, if you're having to sweat and you're really feeling the burn, you'll create a strong abdominal sheet, right? Does that, but if you have body fat gym between that and your skin and the adipose tissue, you're not going to see your work. So you have to put a good diet together, probably cardiovascular work to help lower that body fat with the reduction in calories, to help your abdominal work. And really, you should do your abdominal work about 3 to 4 times a week, and it should be to the point where you can't do anymore.
Okay, so speaking about diet, the next question is, what is the truth about the glycemic index and eating carbs when it comes to just general weight loss? I've cut out all the refined carbs and most of the carbs in general, haven't dropped a pound. What's that all about?
Yeah, and that's one of the bigger issues we get hung up on. Most folks are trying to eat the whole grain. They're trying to stay away from refined carbohydrates. The problem is, whole grain and healthy does not equal weight loss or lower calorie. And sometimes the higher grain, better for you breads will be 80 calories a slice, where the refined stuff that you can wad up in a ball may be 60 calories a slice. They may be higher in calories if they're whole grain. So if you're going to eat healthier, look at the calorie content. It's still reduction in calories. It loses weight. So eat healthy, but do it with the reduction of calories.
But still watch those calories.
Absolutely.
All right. Everyone talks about core training, and my friend recently got rid of her chair at work sitting on a body ball. What exactly is core training, and should I try to do this?
Okay, and this is a real good one, too. Core is not just from here to here. It's like an apple core. Think about when you eat an apple around the core. It's got that lump on the top and the lump on the bottom and that hole in the middle that you've done. Think of that hole as being your waist and your back. It wraps around your entire body. So my lower back, my abs, this whole center is my core. So people are dropping, sitting like this, and putting body balls in their desk where they can't hunch. And they're building a stronger lower back. One lady said her lower back was sore a little bit the first week. I said, I bet. So core training is a good idea. Try ditching your chairs everywhere you're sitting, even at home. Put a body ball underneath you.
Sitting up straighter.
You might want to do it for an hour or so at first and break yourself into it.
Right.
But it's the whole center, and it's worth it.
Thank you so much for coming in on New Year's
Day,
no less. All right. Well, if you would like to get in touch with Candace, you can check out her website at www.fitisitcardio.com or just call her 410-960-0403. She's running.